Came first, the chicken or the egg?
Which came first, the chicken or the egg?
By a long
Bill, me, Charlie, Philip, Leanna, and myself. Alright, now I'm gonna also ask Charlie to get out of here, if you don't like him, for a few minutes. I'm gonna go move in the quiet room closer to yours. Now, if any of you have ever seen Friends, anyway, they play this game a lot. Basically, what's happening, Charlie is hosting a party, and he has a few unexpected guests, which are us. But each of us has some very odd quirk of personality or some strange famous person, and Charlie has to guess who we are. So we need suggestions from you guys as to who we are, what's wrong with us, anything like that. Not all at once. Yes.
Every time someone asks you yes or no question, you have to do a cartwheel.
You can do a cartwheel?
Mm-hmm.
Anyone else? We need two more, please.
You
yes.
have to look at your shoes until someone says and then you look at the ceiling until someone says and again.
Leanna! One more, yes.
Joe Biden.
No, I don't.
ask yes or no questions.
I had to look at the floor until someone said and then I had to look at the ceiling. And then
that was evil!
You know what? I'll find someone else who I can slice eggplants with, and it would be beautiful.
game, I'm gonna need the place where these two people are at. Just anywhere. Place.
Jail.
Jail. This is perfect. You guys are in jail.
Yes!
I know, you've always wanted to. So, Philip here is gonna stop. Philip has an evil twin, myself, but no one really knows about it because he's a little embarrassed about it. But Rachel doesn't know about it either, and I, evil twin, have this habit where I like to insult people. And Rachel, not knowing what evil twin thinks, is Philip insulting her, and so Philip's gonna have to justify my insults to Rachel at prison.
Another day.
Come on, sir! somewhere. Where is she working at?
Burger King.
She's working at Burger King! And she is late. Now she needs a really, really good excuse for why she's late, so that I'll, you know, not fight her on the spot. These two have to tell her what that excuse is. Now, you guys need one more little thing with me. I'm sorry, you guys thought you were done. We need a really, really out there, crazy excuse for why she might be late. These two can kind of mind to it without me knowing. She was abducted by aliens who cut off her tail. Mind to it. Abducted by aliens who cut out her toe. That's why she's
late. Awesome. That sounded like the beginning of a nursery
rhyme. All right. No, it's too late. She's coming. Apparently.
Nice, bro.
God. It's not my fault!
Never.
trying to find and know where it is.
And
play
the pool.
Alright! One of you is trying to find the middle pool, the other is knows where one is. Now, the thing that makes the game actually fun instead of just playing the pool is they will randomly turn to the audience and monologue. Now, this is always funny. I dare you to prove me wrong. Don't tell me to prove me wrong.
I'm
so
sorry.
Listen to the laugh thing!
Lord, man.
Hogwarts.
Yes!
That's right. and we'll see what happens. It's Leviosa, not Leviosa.
But it still won't get up. It won't levitate.
Change.
It won't turn into a frog like that.
Change.
It won't turn into McGonagall like that.
What do you have with McGonagall? She's my lady. I'll duel you.
But she is your lady.
And?
Change.
Yes, she is. Maybe we can share.
Well, you know, if we make some duplicates of them, we won't have to share them.
Can you do that magic?
Indeed, change. I think I can. Change. Of course I change! Oranges can only be orange, can't you know this?
Damn! You're right! I see. Well, what about
but she's still mine!
Are you dancing with me, or are we going
to
go?
No, I'm going to fool you.
No. Well, I better get a
hide!
I'm a jerk of disco time! Let's give some tea. Sodomy in the snow.
I don't know, maybe.
In the house. cigarette lie, and you commit sodomy because the bagels.
Well,
naturally,
generally, I like to use the bagels, you know.
No, I don't.
Great day in Sparta, isn't it?
Hello!
your face and change it up on me.
Go!
Pretty day for a spa today, don't you?
What?
Really, it is.
So I don't think we'll be talking all like this all the time. I figure we should break that trend.
This is Sparta.
All right.
This game is Mission Play. There's two of us, so I guess I'll start with the original. We need a relationship.
Brother-sister,
where are we?
Ice cream shop.
The ice cream shop. Alright, we're a brother-sister in the ice cream shop, but we're going to be acting out a scene once I catch my breath. And this line of people can't see what we're doing, obviously. But at some point, the first person in line, Annette, is going to yell freeze. We have to freeze wherever we are. And then she has to come in and replace one of us in that exact same position and change the scene accordingly. So.
I love ice cream. What's your favorite kind of ice cream?
it. We are always wrong with that audience. So, his last game is called Die, Scum, Die.
Yes!
You do get to yell that favorite phrase that I forced you guys to learn at the beginning. This is how it play. Now, these sort of lovely people will be telling a great story, let me tell you. Now, for the story, let's do the title of the story. You know the title of the story is not actually real yet?
Pleasure for pleasure.
Pleasure for pleasure. I want to see how this story is. Okay. Now, the only reason the story is going to be so absolutely amazing is that, they're not just going to be telling it like one after the other. They're going to be telling it pretty much randomly. I'm going to be choosing to tell the story at any point. Now, if, let's say I'm pointing at Beth and she's talking and I cut immediately to Zach and he does not start his sentence exactly where she left off. She's like, and he has to finish that sentence. If she's in the middle of a word, like interest, you guys have to notice that and kill them when they die. Kill them when they die. No, I'm just going to chair since it's a chair. With pleasure.
Yes, there's one of Shakespeare's. So Billy Joel was walking down the street one day and he ran into his good friend
Billy Bob Thornton, who in fact was in a very, very interesting Shakespearean play known as Crystal Lee, because that of course is one of Billy Joel's
favorite plays from Shakespeare, but this time when
his grandmother came, which was very important because she's with blind and deaf. She and she said, Billy Joel, man, you gotta get off the dock.
Deaf and mute.